expectation is different. Like, if it doesn't go this way, I'm disappointed in a way that I can't explain. Like, expect is dirty, bro. Like,
so, vision. What is the difference? You're trying to visualize and then manifest.
Indeed. But this
they're coming from different places.
But this is what I mean, though. So visualizing and manifesting it is being realistic and knowing this shit might not work out, though. And I'm okay with that. If you expect it, you're not okay with that. Now, I'm not saying take the loss. I'm just saying don't lose the lesson in the loss. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So
because that would truly be losing.
Now you're losing, though.
You're truly losing.
You're losing. You're done. Like, as soon as that happens, I've never lost in my life. There's been times where it looked like and felt like it, but then I'll reflect, I'll get past it and look back. Okay, next time I'll be more prepared to deal with the situation. I know what to do with it now. I'll sit on it, meditate for a couple of days, and think about it.
Yeah.
And it'll come to me, and I'm like, okay. It sucked at that point in time, but because of this happening, this happened. So this door can't open over here unless you come in the front door. Like, all these other doors in the building, you got to come in to open these other doors.
And
most of us look at the building and be like, maybe, I don't know what's in there. Like, I don't care. I just don't care. That's why I say no plan. It's a door. If it's arisen my curiosity, I'm fine with however this goes. Like, if this is the last step I take because it's like a madhouse of shame.
You don't fight anything.
Hell no, bro. I tried to. This is why I went to prison, though. I went to prison for denying myself. Like I jumped into the streets to prove my manhood. Like, you know, I come from, like we don't come from a lot of money, but, like, my mom's from Jamaica and shit. Like, I come from hardworking people.
Mm-hmm.
So, to me, it was just, like, the natural hustler in me because I went overboard with the shit. You know what I mean? Instead of just stopping that Kool-Aid stands and all that shit, it's just like, all right, well, let me grab some weed. And the first time, and everything I do is extreme. The first time I sold weed was the first time I smoked weed. So, I'm talking to the dude and shit, and I'm like, hey, man, I want to get some money. The first time I ever sold weed, he gave me a quarter pound. I'm like, 11, 12. Like, what am I going to do with this?
And it's so interesting because if it wasn't illegal, it wouldn't have, like, sent you down this thing because they, you know what I mean? Like, what they do for, like, that, right? Like, even if you do go down other things, but if, say, that's what you get caught for, right? You get caught for, like, selling cannabis. Right. And then they make this whole crazy, like, mind game of, like, you just, like, doing whatever you need to do to, like, make it here on this planet. Like, the government does that. Or, you know what I mean? Do you see that?
Do you know why they call weed a gateway drug?
Why?
Think about it like this. If it wasn't a bootleg industry, would I have ever had to pick up a gun?
What do you mean?
Like, watch this. Like it's a bootleg industry. Like, it's underground. You know what I mean? Like,
yes.
We're subterranean down here. We're a subterranean economy. The drugs and weed. Just let's stay the weed, though. You know what I mean? So you get weed, and then at some point you grow so much that now people want to come and take your weed.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if this is a legitimate industry, we're not going to be in the shadows with this money. We can be making bank deposits with this money. So I don't have to hide, and then I don't have to have a weapon to protect my earnings.
Yeah, because people will take it.
That's what I'm
saying.
Because
there's no industry controlling it, so it's like, who are you going to call, motherfucker?
Who am I
going to
call, man? Ghostbusters is not coming for you. They're not coming, bro.
Oh, my God. Yeah. They're fucking not coming. That song's not coming on.
Nah, bro.
That's just, you just watch the show a lot, and it's programmed in this fucking thing.
Even though, if you're being literal, that's their field. It's ghosts, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this is a financial crime, right? So it's fucking dead presidents on this shit. This is a Ghostbuster crime. These are dead presidents, man, and this is a financial crime. Come on, but because of that, we're forced to do shit like that. So that type of activity, meeting these type of people, sell guns, now what are you going to do? Introduce to way different people. Okay, he has cocaine. He has you know, anything that's going on.
This
guy got pills.
And why are people altering themselves? Because they're sad. Something's wrong. Something's wrong. Don't you agree?
Man, everybody is suppressed, bro. Like there's no expression. That's what I'm saying to you. Like,
just selling weed, you're already, they try to put you in a box. They try to put you in a fucking box because you're just trying to sell weed. You're just trying to be a businessman. And they're like, no fucking way. We don't care how old you are.
But there's multiple reasons for that, though.
recurring.
It can be.
Yeah.
But like,
well,
even though, like, I see all this bullshit signs and saying, oh, yeah, yeah, I don't like it. Because at any time, like, I could just stop doing anything.
Mm-hmm.
Period. Like,
yeah.
if you don't have some type of discipline and control out of your faculties, man, you're no worse than the animal.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Now you're just moving off a complete instinct. Just, oh, see, dude, you know what I'm saying?
Huh. Interesting. I think I could be a little part of that. That's something I'm working on, you know? But it works out sometimes.
That's what I mean. But it's situation. Everything is situational, though.
You're
right. Like they say, everything done in moderation.
Can't generalize.
It's all situational. Like I say, something like, you sitting on the bike, you saw and did.
Yeah.
So that time it worked out. But sometimes you have your angel dude and your devil dude, and they jumping on him, and they jumping on him. And like, now it's situational. You can't just be like, I want to do this. Hold on now there's ramifications.
Mm-hmm.
You got two daughters.
So you're operating on emotion, right? Like you're operating on emotion versus like consciousness.
Semi-autonomous consciousness.
Okay.
Semi.
Semi meaning like your...
A majority of my life is instinctual.
Mm-hmm.
But then I also have...
I also
have that do not break, or break glass in case of emergency acts. Just in case I need to override this instinct. Break this fucking glass with this axe. Wait a fucking minute. You know? Straight up.
That is the best fucking metaphor I've ever heard. I gotta break the axe. You gotta have that, right?
Yeah.
You never know.
But that's the true separation between the animal and the human is we can override this.
Yes.
When this shit is not right. Not every instinct is beneficial.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So sometimes you gotta
some instincts are bad.
Yeah,
you got some bad.
Because the further and further we got along in our
culture that's like forming these weird thought patterns that we get in, and then we have to break them. We have to
because
break
it's
all.
Not right.
Yeah.
We've been programming it.
You come out, you're naked,
engineer.
Put clothes on. You're illegal. You're
yeah,
illegal
yeah,
as soon as you're born,
put
dude.
Put clothes on. Fuck up your body posture by putting shoes on.
Uh huh.
You know what I'm saying?
Cut
like,
your dick.
Come on, man.
Well, some people.
So you're, but this is that's called denying God. This is bigger than that. Think about what's the
denying
most fun.
Denying God.
That's denying God.
Because you're
I
fighting
can
what's happening.
You. That's been happening though. Not something wrong like global warming or something that just happened because of us. This has been happening. God had us here operating how we were operating.
Uh-huh.
And you want to come in? No.
Now
that wasn't working. That's not
one
the
person's ego is coming in just like fucking. Just wanting to use all that power for bad, like devil dudes running.
That's devil shit, bro.
God,
you're denying God, man. You're trying
yeah.
to deny God. You're like, okay, I can prevent God. You're okay, well, tell me how those levees did.
Yeah.
You can't prevent this shit, man.
How full do you feel really inside?
It's not up to you. And that's what I'm saying. Like, how can you deny God? Because that people are scared of having control taken away. I don't give a shit. I prefer that shit. Like, I'm going to play my role, but I know this shit ain't up to me.
Mm-hmm.
Those people who deny God have the audacity and
it's
nerve
not up
to trick themselves into
it's
thinking
it's not
it
up to us. Like,
this is my choice. This is my decision. No, it's not. Your circumstances are going to dictate your choices.
Yeah.
Period. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
If you're hungry, you're going to eat. That's no longer a choice. I don't
mm-hmm.
want to hear that.
Yeah. It's just binary.
You'll
that's
you'll
a
be,
binary
you'll be superseded.
Thing.
Like,
yeah.
Be arrogant, all that cute shit. You'll be superseded.
Mm-hmm.
That might take a minute. You will be hungry.
Yeah. Has a test for you always.
Every day, every scenario. Once again, go back to how you met me.
Uh-huh.
That's a test, man. Are you
yeah.
going? You, like I'll put it like this: you probably already put it into the ethers. You want a particular type of in here. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, you probably brought me here without understanding that you brought me here. You know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah,
probably
yeah,
in
yeah.
Your mind, you
that's
know,
like
man.
Instinctual.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Manifest destiny.
Yeah.
What do you call that shit? There was that book, The Secret. It's about speaking into existence. What's that shit called?
The law of attraction.
Law of attraction.
The
so,
law
like,
of
that's,
attraction.
That's why the secret is so big, man. So that's what I mean.
Because that mindset.
You already brought me here. Is what
got
I'm saying. And like I told you, I've been looking for this too. And every time I'm looking, I just don't look. I just walk, bro. And then shit that I'm looking
and
for.
And it literally
me.
Drives to you.
And I swear to God.
That's the funniest shit I've ever
no, listen.
I know it's real.
Watch.
I did it.
Watch,
I did
bro.
It.
Watch. How did I meet you, dude? How did I meet you? Just tell me how you met me.
I saw you.
You saw me doing what?
Walking.
Walking, doing what? You saw me walking with my shirt off.
Okay, yeah. I'm on the same. That's why I'm laughing so hard, because it's literally it's literally the literalness in you walking, doing that, and then that's how everything like has worked out. Now that could be dangerous, right? Because like some crazy people could come up and like, you know what I mean? But then look at all the good.
That's an experience too. So I'm not sure.
No, of course. Again, not fighting.
And that's the point. See, that's that devil shit too. The point is to break your faith.
Yeah.
So let's say this has happened to me before. I hung out with strangers and shit, and I got burnt. See, that devil shit.
Uh-huh.
Trying to break your faith. So yeah. Your blessing's gonna come in the same way, but instead of you now, this guy come up on a motorcycle. Oh, I'm scarred. So you're still gonna push your blessing away because your instincts have hardened, and you're like, nope, I'm not gonna go with my instincts. So now you're trying to supersede your instincts, which is denying God sometimes. You're denying your story.
And we forget.
But that's because this person was already scarred, like females and shit, how they're already scarred before they meet you.
Uh-huh.
And you have good intentions.
Yeah.
But through her being scarred, she'll run you off.
Mm-hmm.
You just ran off your blessing. So it's the same thing, this is what I'm saying with life. Like you can't
denial of God.
Denying God. Be cool, man. Let this shit happen. If it's bad, it's gonna happen. If it's good, it's gonna happen. But it's all life, y'all.
That's like the most profound way I've ever heard what people would deem as like religion or God or like whatever we're talking about. Like that's gotta be the most profound way I've ever heard this thing. And it made the most sense. What the fuck? How'd you think about it?
Alright, now look.
Focus.
No.
Clearly. Your body is you know what
it's,
I mean?
It's deeper
like,
than that.
What?
Do you know what's the root word of personality?
No.
It's persona, right?
Okay.
So do you know where that root word came from?
No.
It's Latin for through God. So your personality is God speaking through you. That's where persona means.
What?
Yeah, check it out, bro. Like
I believe you.
Yeah, no, I'm saying like
that's
I always
hilarious.
Say is like
wow.
Like I have a
of course, you're
life.
Not you're not being an absolute type
hell
of
yeah.
Person.
Yeah, I mean like, you know, if you hear this and you're interested, check this shit out.
Yeah, of course.
That,
of course.
I don't even remember where I found out, but I read a lot in prison. I probably read like 1,100 books. You know what I mean? I love reading shit.
Really? See, I'm a listener. Real, like podcasting this,
yeah,
you know, this is what's got my brain so curious. If I didn't get, if I didn't have these, this, all this information coming in,
yeah.
I'd be doing some dumb shit.
Of course, bro.
Like,
once again, denying God, though, man. Like,
yeah.
Like
and these people aren't denying God, right? Those people who are being true and
denying,
real.
Denying your purpose is denying God, bro. Like I say, persona, like, you know what I mean? So I'm not really me. You know what I'm saying? I'm an actuation of God.
Yeah.
So anything that comes out of me, is unless I supersede, is from God. You know what I'm saying? So unless I supersede and say some dumb shit, like if you just let it flow, it's probably not going to be no good.
Mm-hmm.
But as soon as you try to hold back the waters, like I said, the levees,
mm-hmm.
Come on, bro, that's just going to God.
It's operating
show.
On
you're
something.
God.
You've changed. Yeah,
you're denying
right.
Your purpose, which
yeah.
Isn't your purpose.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the thing that we keep forgetting. Like me, I'm not here for me. This is how they tricked us to be, though, like social media and shit like that. They've turned one person into better than the rest. And here's the funny part. They made the people choose it. So the people have chosen to be lesser than
the
people
the
that they love.
Right.
By choice. This motherfucker. Like,
Joe Rogan.
All
and
of,
he's just
all
being himself.
Joe
he's
Rogan's
just
a hell of a
being
guy.
Himself.
My brother put me on his podcast. He's a beast, bro.
What?
But, hell yeah. My brother fucks with this shit heavily, bro. As far as like podcasting and shit. So he's more of a listener, too.
I'm
more of a.
Joe
I,
is
I,
better.
I mean,
that's
why
I
always
have the
has
part.
Like different people from different type of aspects.
He is
just do one thing.
Yeah.
He's just curious as fuck, bro.
Curious,
curious
motherfucker.
Man.
That guy's operating on some god shit.
He really is, man. Like,
no.
And look how much this. Okay, so he was like this forever, right?
Mm-hmm.
Think about how much pride.
No, not forever.
No, I'm
I mean,
saying like for a long time. Like
yeah,
you don't just you just don't.
He was the first podcast, and he's still the biggest.
So
he knew something.
Look, this is deeper than that. Where did he come from? How do we know Joe Rogan?
I know him from Fear
Factor.
Yeah,
you know how much they had
factor.
To burn him up to do that brain dead shit?
Yeah.
But he saw the purpose in his life. Think about this.
Well, he's
he had to be
free.
Damn near a clown.
Yeah.
Like, he wasn't, but that's the role he had to play.
Mm.
He just stood up there, eat a whole bunch of fucking nasty ass shit and count it.
Yeah.
Now think about the person that he is. You know how much that took for him to sacrifice that?
Yeah.
Because he knew he was bigger than that. He's like, man, anybody could sit up here and interview these fools about eating cow dick for $100,000.
It's robbing. Yeah.
He didn't deny God. He paid his due. It's about paying dues. So he had to shovel some shit to get in the path.
Got it. Okay.
You know what I mean? You got to start at the gardener sometimes to get into the mansion.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Dude,
point.
I was an ice cream man yesterday, so don't tell me about fucking. I'm not
I
afraid to
know.
Do that. I'll mop this motherfucker till I'm dead. You
That's
know?
I
was a janitor. You know?
$10 an hour.
Yeah. So that's our difference. We're not bigger than
like
any of this
nothing,
stuff.
Bro, I'm not bigger than nobody. Bro. I'm not bigger than anyone. I'm not appointed. I'm not anointed. I'm nothing that they can't be. Because I came out of a vagina too.
Just like every other motherfucker.
It's just
that's
me.
Here.
I stopped denying God. Even when I was young, like I knew shit was wrong. But I would deny it and still do what the fuck I wanted to. I was trying to live my purpose, my story. There's no such thing as my story. His story, not my story. Like, it's bigger than me, it's bigger than you, bro. It's all about his story. It's the next person.
There's a lot of people coming, so we better get this shit going, right? They better start operating on that, or we're going to kill our, you know what I mean? It's not going to be
gonna
good.
We're going to kill ourselves, bro. Like, everything we do is to numb our inner self.
I mean,
man.
Literally.
Everything we do calcifies our fucking pineal gland, shuts down our reflexes and instincts and our vision. You heard it.
Yeah.
So, you know, everything we do calcifies it. Even eating meat, anything with a mucous membrane you eat calcifies your inner vision, which is your third eye, the pineal gland. And it stops secreting fucking hormones based on. Bro, I stopped eating meat for 7 years. It was the best time of my life, bro. I've never been more clear. Like, I've been back on meat since I got out of prison. I'm about to get off that shit again.
Really?
Bro, it's fucking horrible for you. Because think about it like
what
this.
What about the elk, though, that Rose
once again.
Doing?
So, yeah, he a beast, bro. But look at our natural, look at your teeth, bro.
Okay.
So how much of this food that you eat could you kill if it just ran past you? Could you catch a fucking, could you kill a cow, bro, with your bare hands?
Not with some rocks and some items and shit.
But what I'm saying is you can't do what a fucking wolf can do and just bite
it.
You can't bite into your food and be okay, right?
No.
You're gonna die. Even if you somehow break the hide, we don't have the teeth for that. We have plant eater's teeth, bro. The only thing we have is incisors, and that's to, like, break nuts and shit, bro.
Yeah.
We have, look at our teeth. They're flat like cows, bro.
That is fucked.
So our natural diet is plant-based.
And then someone tried to freak someone out with this with the vampire thing, and then that whole story, like, what the fuck?
And then now we're just on.
That's literally devil stuff. They say
man,
it's devil stuff.
Like,
right? They say vampires
shit,
is devil shit.
Devil shit.
Right?
Devil shit. Pay attention. They didn't lie about none of that shit. They didn't lie.
It's so interesting.
It's fables and parrots. It's all that shit. All watch any cartoon that they designed for us and then strip away the wee. Listen to the fuck their dialogue is. They're not talking to kids.
What are they talking? This is something I'm on. Have you seen Incredibles 2?
No,
and Hotel Transylvania 3.
They understand that shit. They can laugh at it.
Well, of course.
They can't, but the dialogue
is
under the nose, over the head, though. You know what I mean? It's not for kids.
You only
those
get
stories
it.
Are for us at a certain point.
Yes.
Like, people, once again, go back to creators. So how can you give a kid their vegetables? You have to disguise it as dessert.
Uh-huh.
So in a certain forms of that's why the entertainment industry is so fought over between good and evil, bro. Because if you control music and you know, music, that's how people can learn language the best. That's how we learn the best is hearing it through music.
Really?
So why do you think that's the most disputed as far as good versus evil? Like, you know, energy forces trying to control the music industry, why do you think? If you can control how people learn and intake information, you can give them any information you want to give them.
On the internet.
So they stole like that. Look at this like this, man. They stole any music that was positive and morphed it into what we have today, modern day rap.
And so what do you listen to now? Who's like your inspiring, who's your person that's speaking in a way that blows your fucking mind? Who? Do you have one? Are you it? Okay.
Okay, so I think more of me, to be honest. But I think so, bro. I think I keep me moving. Because I have real honest conversations with myself. And it's my best dialogue.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, like, I've never, like, I've seen some people close and go,
truthful.
Pretty much the all knowing shit, man. But that's one. That's trippy too, man. That's a matrix shit going like
way
that.
Way crazy.
The internet is pretty heavy because it's like it shouldn't even be called the internet because just the word the internet is pretty much to me. I can see the internet. Like when I walk outside of here, I can see an actuation of the internet because everything out here is on the internet. You can get a house. You can buy a McDonald's. You can buy something from McDonald's. You can buy some tires. You can buy some shit from Walmart on the internet. So it's physical because I can walk outside and do the same thing.
Yeah.
The internet is physical now, bro. The internet is literal.
Yeah. I was living there the whole morning. I got so much shit done.
Yeah, you can get a lot of shit done.
I get a lot. I'm not just,
as long
you know.
As you see, that's the thing about the internet, man. Use it for progress.
Yeah,
not progress, not happiness. Not from boredom. Like, most people go in there reflexively now. Like, I was glad I was in prison and didn't develop into this stuff. At the dinner table and shit, doing that shit. Like, I see it all the time. Like,
yeah.
Are you guys hanging out or
locked in the phone, Facebook,
and not for progress. Like, if you have something to offer the world,
yes,
you need that shit. Like, that's why I don't have that much stuff now, except for music. I have music stuff on the internet, but that's it. Because that's what I have to offer the world currently. And then this fall, I'll have my clothing on there.
I got videos. We're already recording. This is it's done.
Doing your shit, but you're utilizing the internet in a proper manner, man. Not on there because it's not about
I do
you.
Have a specific intention. I do.
It's a proper manner. It's a proper manner. So it's, at least it's not for boredom or vanity purposes. Because that once again, that's devil shit. But like vanity is demonic shit, but they tricked us into trying to do that. So motherfuckers just self. I'm just gonna go to the gym, but you never worked out your mind. So really, the working out, your body's gonna take care of itself as far as what it's gonna look like. That's the side effects. Working out to me is for the spiritual and emotional connections I can get through that shit through physical activity.
Because it's so honest and true, huh?
So if it looks good, cool.
Yeah.
But that's a side effect. Now that's the point. Be an airhead and look good in the camera and mirror. You just suck. I got like 20 pictures in my phone, bro. And they're all of like my kids or some shit. I don't even take pictures. I feel like it takes, unless like it's purpose, like I say, but for me, I'll be so lost in my moment.
Yeah.
Like I can't be having fun and be like, oh shit, snap. I'm really in the moment, bro.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't create the moment. I'm of the moment. You know what I'm saying?
I get that.
Once again,
that
I'm not denying
that. Very, very, very profound. Because I feel that. But there's this sharing it.
No, I'm speaking
it's
on my.
No, I get it. I get it.
Like
I
if you're you're trained, so cameras is part of your discipline. And like I say, you're doing it for a purpose. You're not on here for vanity's sake. Sharing. That's the word you keep saying over and over and over again. You didn't. I haven't heard you say the word I like. Why, bro? You know what I'm saying? Unless it was in another word.
Because it's not fun.
Well, that's a dirty vowel too. It's no wonder I is one letter. The loneliest motherfucking word, bro. One letter, bro. Like, that's lonely. I is lonely, bro. You know what I'm saying? There's a reason, man.
I never caught on that. Yeah. Man, the words. The words that you gotta catch.
Hell yeah.
The whoa. What's that?
Semantics. Yeah. That's why I'm so big on semantics, too. Bro. What are you saying without saying?
Just like a movie. Just like a fucking movie.
Well, that's life, though. Everything is going to be
hidden in
plain sight. Everything will be hidden. God will hide everything for you in plain sight. But once again, you have that option, that ungodly option to supersede this or proceed with your mission. Supersede or proceed? Which sounds better to you, pro or super? See how they're trying to trick you?
Yeah.
See how they're trying to trick you?
Super, huh?
Super sounds good. So what do? We supersede and deny God all these times. Because of how they dress the word. Super sounds, you know what I mean? Better than pro.
Yeah. Fuckers.
But now that I know, pro is professional. Come on, man. So I'm going to professionally see, which is concede. You know what I'm saying? I will professionally submit to the will of God, bro. That's what proceed means to me.
So I'm freaking out because I made this mix and talking about professional, and there was this exact spot that I'm, like, you know, I'm picking very calculated, like, ways of saying things. Because, like, for me, it's memory. But I'm, like, putting this all, like, I don't know, for me, in the way that I'm, like, doing stuff, you know what I mean? Like, helps me keep it all together. I don't know if that's maybe it's a side effect of, like, I don't know. I just fuck, dude. I hear Rogan joking about it. He's like, oh, dude, I gotta start deleting files in my fucking brain. You know what I mean? Like, I'm trying to, like, actually stay in control of things, you know? And with, like, a specific thing. So, with that said, I gotta find this. I gotta find this, and I wanna hear what you think. Because you've been blowing my mind.
Likes or followers you have. I have a funny feeling
that everybody know what we be, boys and girls.
Write down what you would like to fix about your life. And then just, if you're 30 pounds overweight, you want to lose 30 pounds, do it the right way. Go start eating vegetables, monitor your calories, write down what you eat, exercise every day, force yourself to do it. The brain is the general, the troops are the body, and you get up and you do it, and then you get to write it down. Our bodies, for whatever reason, most people, their associations are to avoid anything that's uncomfortable. It's so illogical, because when you look at comfort and you look at success and progress and the feelings of accomplishment and of getting past certain hurdles in terms of, like, how you feel about life, a lot of those are connected to discomfort. Like, discomfort is your friend. It really is. Like, discomfort and not being happy and content with certain situations in life or certain feelings in life. One of the big problems is sitting down and doing the work. And he labels it like an enemy. He calls it resistance,
mm-hmm.
You know, and that you have to sit down, you have to overcome resistance, and that the pro goes to work. And it doesn't matter if you're sick, doesn't matter if you have kids, it doesn't matter what, you're a pro, and you go to work. And that just, it puts it in your head that this is what I do. You have pride in that. And then when you are in front of that keyboard and you look down the count, it says put 1,000 words in. You're doing the work.
Yeah.
And out of that work, gems blossom. And it's about resistance that people feel when you know you should write, or you know you should paint, or whatever, you should sculpt, whatever these things are that you pursue. And that there's this thing that comes up that tries to keep you from doing that. This resistance. You're not a hero in your own eyes. You're not someone who you respect.
You know what magicians do, right?
What?
They don't give you three choices like they said. The way they use their words,
you know, you're doing what you got to do to get by, but ultimately, you're not respecting yourself. And I think we all have a certain amount of appreciation and respect for hero figures. You know, like, we all look at, like, the guy who never lies and always does the right thing and fucking helps everybody out. And that's the John Wayne character. You know, that's the ultimate hero.
Looks like this is all.
And he's like, this is a battle that you will fight for the rest of your life. But the key is to fight it, not to give in. Don't give in to that resistance.
Yeah,
to fight, just to fight that resistance. And in doing so, every day you do so, you have won the battle for that day. And you will continue to fight that battle. And when you look at your own life and you don't stack up, you're a thief, you stole money from your wife's purse, and, you know, you don't want to smoke cigarettes, but you fucking have to, you can't deal with the stress of smoke, you devalue yourself. You slowly start devaluing yourself. You look at yourself and you realize that if you were judging yourself, you would judge yourself unfavorably. So no matter who you can't pretend you're the hero of your story.
But they tricked you into thinking, no, I gotta be rich now.
You can be the hero of your own story that woke up today. You can be the hero of your own story that at 40 years of age stopped, got out of bed, and said, I'm not doing this anymore. Only by my instincts and only by my morals and my ideals and my mind, and I'm going to be dead honest with myself because I'm realizing this is is not going to last forever.
Poor people, rich people are in the middle.
And I'm going to get myself in shape, and I'm going to eat healthy. And I'm going to do this, because this is me now.
They're comfortable with discomfort. I come from poor people, bro. I'm comfortable with discomfort. We don't kill ourselves.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
I decide that this is
rich people with their kids, like, people who
and people have to realize that you are not your past. You are not all the times you fucked up. You're not all the times you were drunk.
That's what people weren't meant to be rich.
That's not you. You are the person who's learned from a great deal of experience. When you're alone with your thoughts, you get an idea of what your thoughts actually are. You live your life just acting constantly on the momentum of other people's expectations, of you wanting to be liked by these other people. You can run into a trap, and you set up a life that you didn't really want. Your life is certainly some sort of a journey. It's certainly some sort of a journey.
Problems with all you guys to occur, so none of you motherfuckers come over.
You're trapped in this situation where you have a mortgage, you've got credit card bills, you've got student loans you have to pay, you have a bunch of shit going on that you have to continue to feed. And all that, and especially if you have a family and you have to feed them, oh my goodness. Then you're fully locked in. You can't take any chances whatsoever. And oftentimes people make the mistake of getting stuck. And it is just a tactical mistake, just like it would be a mistake if you got stuck on a video game. Just like it would be a mistake if you followed a map incorrectly and you got stuck in the woods.
Dude, there's a... Oh, what? Makes sense with the blind person's doing.
Your life is certainly some sort of journey.
What they're doing.
It's certainly some sort of journey.
That's what they're
and
doing.
And we have to all be aware
that's
of
that.
That's
the art.
We're not going to always make
oh
the right
my
steps.
God! No one teaches you this shit, man.
You can't back up and try again.
That's why this
you
is important, that we have these conversations and help, because there's kids are, man, they may not be,
instead of
they may never get this conversation.
Now, instead of they still look back at a mistake they made, and don't just get past that mistake, grow and learn, but dwell on it. I think it defines
you can see shit better when you don't focus on it.
Yeah.
I mean,
like
there's definitely
the
pitfalls
like
in
not
life.
Better,
you're going to run into them. We all are. No, you can learn and grow if you're
surrounded. If I look at you right now,
somewhere along the way, it blurs out the adversity to realize that there's sometimes you just gotta get up.
Yeah, okay, I see.
Sometimes you have to fucking pull yourself up.
I can't see one thing super clear.
And you have to push forward, even if you want to stay in bed.
Being super clear and too focused on one thing.
Having that safety net just provided him with a way to stay in bed. Kept him. Have an opportunity. Every time things go wrong, every time things feel terrible, you have an opportunity to learn from whatever makes you feel terrible.
It's
never allowed to happen again. Push forward.
There is nothing, like my mom asked me,
the system will set out honeypots for people to get trapped in. The system will set out the ideas of retirement, the ideas of the golden years, providing you benefits, providing you a healthy work environment. Why? Well, because they want people to work for them. They don't want people to realize their own dreams and escape. They want to set it up so they can stick around. Stick around some sort of an unsatisfying world. It's up to you to see that video game problem. See that issue as it comes up on the map. No, I think this is a right turn. To see all the problems that could potentially lay in front of you and calculate your future. And then also look around all the people that didn't do it and look at the misery that they're in and learn that you don't want to be like that.
I was physically removed. But I was mentally present.
Yes.
I was omnipresent. I was up here. I could see it. I started looking from outside the fishbowl. I went to prison.
That we are powerful beyond.
I get away from the feelings and pleasures of life. Like, pleasures is really the enemy, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, the only reason that it fucking feels good is to make you do it again so the chances of continuing the species are up. That's it, bro. Like, fornicating.
sugar's not there.
It comes
the
from the meat and processing, bro. Meat and processing, bro.
Okay, so that brings us full circle back to the Rogan question. What about he's doing elk hunting? What do you think about that?
Oh, killing an animal?
We think, yeah, he's eating it. He's very big on, like, just
that,
meat. Well, I know, but is that healthy? You're saying the processing of the meat is what's bad, right?
I'll say this, right? Like, who do you revere fighting? Like, who do we look into most?
I mean, like, as a fight, like a fighter.
Who do we think pretty much grandfather?
Yeah, okay. Yes, from a martial, yeah, full martial arts. I didn't know, sorry, I didn't know
you
if you were talking about full, yes,
yeah, like
okay,
not,
Bruce
not
Lee,
the,
yeah, his
much,
mindset, yes,
like,
boom, this guy was already speaking it,
so he said it
doing
probably,
it.
Probably.
What did he say?
Just look at the way you live in the shoe, hey, bro,
no, I don't
awesome.
Know, I'm not clued in,
out, you know,
not
but
clued
that
in.
Was like the type of life he lived, bro, you know what I mean, like, there's a reason we revere five Mongolian guys like that, they were so pure-hearted because they weren't on that shit.
Just type it in. Let's just see. Bruce Lee's diet. I like the I like fucking the mindset behind it.
It's
like
too,
if
too
you start, you know what I mean.
His meats are chicken and fucking fish. So if you eat those once or twice a week, I think you'd be fine.
Only twice a week?
I do it like once a week when I ate like.
So then, what do you eat? How many times? Okay,
rice
let's start with this.
Rice
how many times?
It depends. Like,
how many times a day do you eat? Two, three, two times. Yeah.
Like two meals, I probably snack throughout the day. You know what I'm
mm-hmm.
saying? Like only when I need it, bro. Like I don't try to just do it because I
same.
Can't. Like, I
same. But you don't claim a diet, correct?
Nah.
Me either.
Nah.
See, I'm
it's a
like,
restriction again. It's another,
yeah.
It's another battle.
I flow. Yeah, I'm
so
flow with my body
yeah,
with in
it,
every
man.
Moment.
Like, I'm with it.
Got
whatever.
It.
However, man, I'm not here to deny shit, bro.
Okay. Okay.
As
got
soon
it.
As you say I'm this, that means you're anti that.
Yeah, and you don't want to. Yeah.
So you'd be like, I'm a vegan. That means a vegan literally is rejecting everything that's not a vegan,
yeah.
right?
Only.
I'm not a rejecter.
Yeah.
As far as like good shit.
Uh huh.
I'm not rejecting shit.
Check
I'm
this.
Not here for that.
My friend says this. Only Lord Sis deal in absolute.
Yeah,
devil
yeah.
stuff, right? Like
yeah,
just
yeah.
funner
no,
way,
no,
like
real.
Star Wars.
That's
Lord.
Real, yeah, that's what they said in Star Wars.
I don't know what they said.
That's what they said.
Oh,
Star
okay,
War.
That's
I
what they
said.
Then. Oh, okay.
Yeah, because
only
this,
Lord
this
Sis dealing absolutes. Okay, that is off the movie, huh?
Yeah, he
I think he fucking came up with the quote.
No,
oh God.
Right, yeah, you can gave him Yoda's quote. But no, it's so much game in Star Wars, bro.
Oh
they got
man.
Game for life. If you get past all the zzzz.
Yeah.
Like
of course,
really
the bigger thing they're
the
talking
force,
about.
Bro, the force.
Fucking George Lucas.
Hold on, the force. Chi. Life force. The force. Chi. Life
Bruce
force.
Bruce Lee.
Right?
Eastern. What the fuck is up with the Eastern people?
Well, you see how things are coming back to the East.
The West. The people that went to the West, they're like, they were looking for money. They're looking for, like, I want to live how I want to live.
The devil shit.
Denied. Not okay rejected. With where we were, huh?
Rejected. Like, it wasn't good enough for you? Your ancestors weren't good enough for you?
You want to move away? Oh, it's like that. It's that literal.
And not for nothing bad.
Oh,
you
my.
You want to reject yourself, bro? Like, this is you. Your ancestors are like you, right? You're an amalgamation of their experiences, their taste. Not your taste, bro. You are predisposed to a lot of shit based on your ancestors, bro.
Mm-hmm.
What
yeah.
you think? You predisposed to this. I don't give a fuck
yeah,
bro.
Yeah,
you was drawn
yeah.
to this.
We're
bro.
Already in the cycle.
Come
you're
on, bro,
you're in the
saying,
cycle. Again, don't try
saying.
And fight.
You're part of the chain. You're not
yeah.
the chain, bro.
Huh.
Be a link, man. There's no problem. Everybody got to
be
a part.
Link.
Be a link, bro.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Motherfuckers wasting trying to be a home. Be the whole fucking for what? Because they want to be revered.
Mm-hmm.
The fuck is wrong with you, bro?
Yeah.
You're in it for the wrong shit.
Yep.
Vanity, once again.
Yeah.
All this shit comes back to the same. It's 360 degrees. It's always going to spin back.
That's why
vanity,
mushrooms
bro.
Are so crazy, because they show you all this stuff. The ego, they show you, you know, like the ego
true.
Death. Right?
LSD, weed, those are the three things that I think you're supposed to do, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Weed, shrooms, LSD, bro.
Yeah,
I think
agree.
Everybody should do that.
I agree. And they should float, too.
They go,
I suggest that, all right?
Go for it.
Feels good. Get in the float pod. Here's the mushrooms. You'll be all right. No, I don't know. Some people have no willpower. This is what me
see,
and you have a hard
thing
to realize.
No, it's
because we
bro,
have
it could
so
be dangerous.
it. You just can't understand it, right?
Fly. Go fly real quick. Tell me how that works out.
Yeah, because, like, I understand what you're saying, but then a part of me is like, well, wait, hold on a second. Like, how did I do this?
Once again, what did you just say to me? Oh, no, absolutely.
Yeah.
You just said that. You just answered your own question.
Wait. Hold on. What do you mean?
You answered that. So sometimes it can go this way, sometimes it can't. But the majority is to be respected, is what I'm saying. So there's exceptions to every rule.
Oh, yeah. You can't understand it. Like you said.
This goes back to the supersede and proceed thing. Like, sometimes superseding is necessary.
Mm-hmm.
Situational. Is everything situational? There are no absolutes.
Of course. Yes.
So it's all the same. It's all the same theory. There's no absolutes and it's all situational.
Mm-hmm.
I just remember that all the time. Because there's always going to be a time where you're like, nah, remember I did this.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, you're right. You did do that. We're not talking about you right now, bro. You know what I'm saying? And we're not talking about that. That happened as an exception to the rule. Like, if you're 7 feet tall,
mm-hmm.
that's like saying, man, I ain't never seen 7 foot tall motherfucker. And then one person comes up, okay, that's the exception. He's exceptionally tall. He's not the rule. He's not the average. I'm talking about the average.
Yeah.
So
okay.
as the majority, the general rule, life is a certain way. And then you have the supersede button.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like,
yes, spectrum.
It's a wide range. In this
let me introduce you to why I have these motherfuckers right here, okay?
Yeah.
This is spectrum for me.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
All colors. Gay as shit, groovy, yeah. Whatever the people wanted to make fun of that.
Yeah.
We're going to make fun of you because you like all the colors. You don't just like one color.
Right?
Like, you just like one fucking color. One color. I'm not about that.
So as you see.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Uh-huh.
Going on.
Yeah, whatever.
If it works, if it doesn't, fucking.
Yeah. Yeah, but the reminders, dude, this. Again, I don't know what it is. Maybe I just have shitty memory or something, but a lot of my stuff that I'm doing, I'm like, man, that's a lot of memory stuff. Well, I mean, you want to know, I guess, it's just as you're going through the process of living, you're trying to become wiser. I don't want to make the same mistakes again, over and over and over. That's literally the definition of insanity. I don't want to be insane, you know? So I try to be, like, just on my ass about, you know what I mean, stuff. Because I wasn't a good student of, like, the typical way. But I am a good student, is the thing.
Speaks to you, that's the thing. You're not programmed.
Mm-hmm.
I don't look at it like this. Most of those people who are super smart are smart in their realm. So there's actuation or, like, there's actuation or intelligence.
Okay.
And then there's, like, group intelligence. So Malcolm Gladwell, you up on him? You know what I'm saying? Come out of the Great Depression, do all type of other shit, go to a certain city in a certain place at a certain time in life for him to turn out how to do it.
Yeah.
So it was
a long
chain of events that turned into Steve Jobs. But
yeah.
And if any of them change, the whole story changes. No such thing as that.
Literally, there's no such thing as that.
It doesn't even exist, bro. You know what I mean? So change one
this
thing, change all things.
He got obsessed.
He was tripping.
Do
I'm
you
not
think
say he was a good
did?
Dude. He was
you know, but the
I know,
what's
I know,
with
I know
the
dude who worked with him as far as like promotions and shit. He was like, man, he was brilliant. He was a fucking ass.
Yeah, this
dude,
is.
Bro, like, no one who worked with him will ever say that.
Mm-hmm.
But.
So he's operating on money. Is that.
No.
Like,
his mind was in the right place, but his application was, I have so zero tolerance for anything but this.
Oh.
But
don't you think God's like that in a way? Well, no. No, yeah, because that's true.
God
he wouldn't fight what he made. Got it,
that's
okay.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
okay.
That's why I say focusing on one thing is a maybe thing.
Mm-hmm.
But Michael Jordan had to be that way to be who he was. But at the same time,
that about Michael Jordan?
I'm being honest, though.
No, you're right. I agree with you.
What has he done for the world? What has he moved forward? He made some people play basketball, like, or make people buy $300 sneakers and people get killed over that shit. Like, what has he done that was just profound? That's it. He played something very well.
And never stopped focusing on it.
What if he had other gifts to give us, and because of him focusing on this so singularly, we never got that? Think of it like that, bro. So maybe that motherfucker owes us, bro. Maybe Mike owes us.
Michael Jordan, you just got called out. Look what LeBron did.
Yeah, he doesn't have a fist. He's different, man. He doesn't have a singular focus. He's using his
clearly
platform.
Not.
He has a platform to do this to better this.
You read everything
he's
doing. You read
like
everything he's doing with his school
everything
and everything. You saw all this. Okay.
I have nothing for him, but like as a man. Best people have multiple disciplines, man, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not saying like I'm the best person or anything.
No,
I strive to be, so I'm interested in everything, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, all right, bro. Because if you don't try a lot of shit, you'll never know what's really for you.
Your
like,
experience is
like,
so limited.
And you're limited. You might be like, man, I'm the greatest martial artist ever and shit. And then you fuck around and pick up a book and it turns out, man, bro, I could be an astrophysicist. Damn, bro, I could fuck around with my two pound is open up orphanage to fucking Timbuktu some damn.
Yeah.
I done went here to change my life. You know what I mean? So
yeah.
Shit like that. Bro. You never know until you see what's up. And then maybe you'll double back and be like, matter of fact, I was.
Yeah.
This is the path. This is the path for me to change many people's life positively. That's life. Me, bro.
Yeah.
Like, and knowing when to say it's enough. Like, nothing here is forever.
Yeah.
And that's cool, bro.
Yeah. At any moment, yeah. So I had an experience. This story I always, you know, use a reference to because it's just, you know, it's my experience. And like, you know, when I'm like going down this martial arts path, it's like, okay, I'm gonna achieve it. I want that belt, and that's gonna fill me up. And no, it doesn't. Especially when someone comes inside and steals it, and then all the kids are right here, like. I knew the energy that I would have ran on, and when the kids are right there watching me, like, I can't let this person, like, affect me. I can't let them come in here, like, okay, whatever, you want to take the belt, that's fine. Like, that doesn't define me. I'm okay. Take all my clothes.
I already did that shit, though.
Yeah, you can't take what I did. Yeah, it's
so you
already
taking
done.
That is something that means more to you because you're coming to stay.
Yeah.
Don't mean that much. Uh-huh.
Yeah, something about being around kids. You've been around kids a lot. You love kids. Yeah, I get. Yeah, kids are just mad. Godly.
My life's aspiration is to assist kids.
That's what I'm doing.
Like, when I can double back. Like, me, I always want to do something like this, but, like, open it up to kids and shit, let them come through. Like,
yeah.
If they come from, like, a certain amount of money or below, let them come in.
Of course.
Type shit. So, like, I always wanted to get a gym.
Oh, well, there is no always or, huh, we're right here.
Yeah.
We're literally right here, and I already have a bunch of kids who are coming, and this is already happening, and I want to share that with people who are on the same page. You know what I mean? Like, and I want, like, people to start their own brand. Like, my brand's everywhere. Like, I want everyone else to have that. I don't want them to be like, oh, I'm Power Promotions or I'm, you know what. Like, I want you to have your own thing. Like, that's kind of like a huge.
You're a facilitator, bro. You're a point guard.
Wow.
John Stockton. I'll just say, where are you from? John Stockton.
That's me.
Well, who do people like to play with more? Facilitator or shoot?
Yeah, that's true. I do like that. I love the energy coming together of people. I think it's one of the most magical things. Yeah.
Pass. Pass.
what, you know what I mean? Like, especially, did you watch Cody and TJ Garbrandt, Cody Garbrandt and TJ Dillashaw? It was a rematch. They trained together.
Yeah, they
Cody
camp,
was
right?
Really,
they
yeah, same
California.
Camp, California, Uriah
yeah.
Faber. Yeah, I know Uriah, trained with him. Like,
was that Team Alpha Male?
Team Alpha Male, yep. Justin Buchholz was the head coach there. No, go ahead, right there. But yeah, Justin
yeah,
Buchholz
so
was the head coach. Yeah, they, he left. No, TJ left them. TJ left, Cody's still there. So Cody's like trying to fight this fight that's really with Uriah Faber. And so that's why I think he lost. It's not like really his fight.
Yeah, you did exactly. What's wrong with you, bro? That wasn't for you anyway. That's why your energy couldn't come together.
Yeah.
This ain't got nothing to do with you.
Nothing to do
you
with you.
You cannot interfere, bro. That's another thing.
It's like, these two business.
We don't really pay attention to, but it's real shit behind
yeah.
it. Little sayings like that.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Well, it's the mantra,
yourself.
Right? When we get in patterns of bad mantras, right? Like bad stuff you're saying over and over. I always fall. Guess what you're going to always be doing? Falling.
Yeah,
you know,
you
right?
Make that happen.
Yeah.
You
manifest your words into
make,
reality.
Make your own luck, bro. Come on, man.
Yeah.
You got to manifest your feelings to it. Manifest that, bro. Put it out there, it'll come back. That's what I'm saying about returning energy.
The match. And that's what you're really into, huh? Right? Like if someone brings fire to you, you're like, fuck, I got the fire
what
too.
What did you just say?
What? Fire?
Match.
Yes.
Match.
They're matches.
Imagine
what?
Mike will match in these fires. They about to trade energy, bro.
Ah, okay.
That's the thing about it like this, bro. Like, look at the sportsmanship after you guys beat the shit out of each other.
Uh-huh.
Unless, you know, it's some other shit sometimes.
Yeah.
Or it's just like,
mm-hmm.
But shit, that's the most spiritual thing you can do.
Yeah. Yeah, I never
trade
have
energy,
had. I've never had a bad or, like, malicious thing. I've always had, and it's almost been a fault, I think.
It can't.
In a fight, it
can. In fighting, yeah.
In a fight, it can.
Sometimes you
because
gotta
I'm so respecting. I'm just like, wow, dude, you're really going to do this with me? Like, I'm almost, like, touched by, like, in the craziest of, like, love ways
yeah,
that you ever could
home.
Be. You know, and, like,
sure.
the most no homo. Like,
yeah,
you're daring. Both of us are going to dare to do this and experience this together. And only us are going to, like,
it's
know
it's
what happened and feel it. Right? That's why, like, my training partners and the people that I do this with, it is the most bonding, most honest, you know what I mean?
You're a business owner, right? You've always tried to be, right?
Yes.
So you like to train.
Uh-huh.
Match, train. This is why that's such a revered thing. This is what I'm saying about not being rich. A trade is even for even.
Yeah.
So it's an energy thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
To
it
be
is
rich, I got to pay this motherfucker 50 cents. He has to pay his employee $2. He has to pay his employee $45. He got to pay his 8, 10, 15. Me to be a billionaire.
It's
that's
this.
Not even. Where the fuck is that even at anywhere, bro? Like, yo, billionaire, the supply chain starts at 50 cents. I'd rather trade. This is why that's such a spiritual thing. Like, we were traders first. The caravans used to come together. All right, bro. All right, I got some gold and some shit on this camel. What you got, bro? 15 goats. Two wild horses.
And my daughter.
You can have my daughter. He's like, and if you give me some of that fucking silver and jade, you can get this. It's a trade, though. Like, we're coming to terms on a trade. We're matching up, bro. You know, it's a trade. It's spiritual.
Yes,
bro. It's
yes.
never supposed to be like this and this, bro.
Uh-huh. It's like, I'm better than you.
Balance, bro. Like, I'm a Libra, man. So that's, I guess that's probably
oh, you're a Libra.
That's probably what makes me
when
feel
are
like
you
the
born?
Is
October 19th.
Yeah, yeah.
So you were right there.
Yeah, so that's why I'm so big on balance and shit. Fairness and being on the side of justice and righteousness.
you studied that heavily.
Nah,
so you,
nah,
no,
I
no,
as far
okay.
As like, astrology and shit,
uh-huh.
I look
or like
it.
Do you look at maybe not even the astrology of it, like just like what a Libra is.
Oh yeah, I'm very aware that I'm pretty much quintessential.
Oh okay, see, so I've not done that. I think I need to do that. I think I need that because like
are
I've been so yeah October
19th, yeah,
89,
yeah,
89.
Yeah, so yeah, bro, like you're probably quintessential.
But I think that's part of my like deeper thing with like religion, like because I was raised LDS,
yeah,
and it was always the worst. Oh really? Oh wow. Oh okay.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
they try
mom,
to put
my
you
mom
in a
mom
box,
and
it's.
Dad got married overseas before you came to LDS.
What?
But I got that shit stuff.
Uh
huh.
It's crazy.
Horrible,
it's
like,
crazy
that's
shit,
just
man.
Shit up.
So I have a lot of like, you know, I'm still unprogramming. I'll probably be unprogramming for as long as I was in there,
sure.
So like 20 whatever years.
Detoxing, bro.
Man, I'm detoxing all the time, and I gotta remember because I'll go back to that. I'll go to more, you know,
yeah,
that
yeah.
Those constructs and stuff. Like,
sure.
whoa, Sean, like that's they just programmed that in
they
there. They programmed that fucking shit in. They raped you.
Like
I've been raped.
All of this, what you mean, society, social engineering is rape, bro. Like,
oh my god.
It's pillaging, bro. It's programming, cuz like programming is
rape.
Doing
those
something
fucking
against
rapists, dude.
Bro,
wow, what the fuck? That
was again taking.
That's a lot to
you're
take in right now, dude.
Taking.
That I just found out I got raped.
Yeah, bro. They
like,
took, bro.
It's probably like a girl when she, you know what I mean,
that's what
gets
I'm
drunk.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
And then
like, taking. This goes back to the word take.
Okay,
all, it's
okay.
All full circle, bro. Take is dirty shit you can do. It's not even. You're taking, you're removing, you're doing.
Okay, got
you're
it.
You're stealing, bro.
Mm-hmm.
That's the most evil shit you can do, bro.
Okay.
Yeah, but I like, I'm into Robin Hood shit, though. So, like, let's say, I don't, like, if you do the wrong thing for the right thing, I'm still into you. You know
like
what I'm saying?
An example. Give me an example.
So like
I still
like
snowboard
like
and let my friend use it. Like,
no, like on some Robin Hood shit. Like, I'm into that. Like, all right. If, or if you had to sell weed, man,
uh-huh.
To feed your kids and shit. I'm,
oh, okay,
I'm
okay,
into
okay.
That,
got
man,
it. Okay.
I understand. Sometimes you got to fall back to go for it.
Mm-hmm.
I understand that stuff.
I'm just selfish. Stole fucking skis to get money.
Oh, yeah,
because the program
programmed
me to think
program
that that's what I need.
And you're a program societally to believe, like, well, I need this particular type of skis, or I'm not going to get accepted into this. It's all bullshit.
But now I don't give a fuck.
Yeah,
now I'm like, cut my shorts, or this, or you know, just
yeah.
I'll just do anything to, like,
be myself. It's fucking great. Pretty cool.
And that's what a fucking comedian is. And that's why it's so, I'm just like, what? That's a job?
Yeah.
That's possible? And it's
going to
be
yeah,
out
awesome.
In the front of everyone? And everyone's
gonna
laugh about it, and no one's gonna not, and no one's gonna arrest you. No one's arresting comedians, right? There's been nothing against comedians. No one can be mad at a comedian. We're just trying to make people laugh. We have very good arguments of like,
yeah.
What?
Like
comedians are smart. Yeah.
Hell yeah, they're smart, bro. Because the perspective that they have, the only thing that makes something funny is it's something that you can relate to but didn't look at it like that. That's what makes a comedian a beast. He interprets it differently. All he's doing is looking at something you've gone through and you can relate to, because it's not funny if you can't relate to
no,
it.
No, yeah, of course.
If
yeah, because
you know,
we
you
go
like
off experience.
If you make a joke about a horse and you don't even know what a horse is, you can't, bruh.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Like,
that's really weird.
I don't even know what that is. So
yeah.
They relate to you to make you look at it like this. And you're like, oh, shit, I've done the same thing
yeah.
Differently. You
mm-hmm,
know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's all it is.
Well, and maybe they're showing themselves in everyone else.
They have a two-sided mirror. That's all it is.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
I'm you're me. That's the whole point of comedy. And they'll say it throughout the show without saying it.
Yeah.
I'm you're me.
I just have the balls to get up here and say it.
I just have the balls to get up here, and I've been blessed with a vision. That's all. That's all a comedian is. Like, God given a vision, bro. It's the most godly shit you can have. You know what I mean?
So when you say blessed, is that kind of like a trigger word for me?
Yeah, me
I don't
too,
exactly
me too,
know.
Me too, me too.
Like, what do you mean,
blessed? I don't like that either, but it's fortuitous, bro. Like, and if you use your gifts the right way. That's why I don't like people say feeling blessed today. Everybody's blessed. You know what I'm saying?
Always.
Like, that's what
and
I mean.
Christmas
as far
is
as
every day. And
like,
yeah.
As far as, like, that's what I mean about the evening shit. So that is a dirty word, too, but for lack of a better word, that's why I sometimes use it. But
no, I know,
far,
and it's memory, and it's like.
So if you have certain abilities and you take
I'm
advantage of them, you're that's
Yes, I agree.
It doesn't matter how you're going to reject yourself. Mm-hmm. That's really your mission is who you choose to accept. Well, it's a mission of possible.
Yeah.
If
yeah.
you choose to accept, if you do.
Cruise. No, Ethan Hawke. Ethan Hawke.
Yeah. Ethan Hunt, yeah. So
oh,
it,
Hunt.
It,
yeah,
it,
not Hawke.
Yeah,
Ethan Hawke's the vampire dude.
Yeah.
Yep, Denzel. Ooh, oh, he was married to Uma Thurman?
Yeah,
oh wow, dude, she's
she
gorgeous. Yeah, she's gorgeous, man.
Ethan Poe, do you
know? Huh, no, Ethan Hunt. Yeah, you're right. Good call.
Yeah, bro, but yeah, man, yeah, we all got a mission. It's just a matter of belief. Denying is when it comes back to that. I've been denying my mission for 10 years, bro. Like,
mm-hmm.
I'm in the streets, bro. Like, I'm not going to sit here and act like that, bro. I don't
yeah.
have a job, I'm in the streets.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know
yeah.
what I mean? But that's not me.
Yeah.
I don't like that shit. It's more of a means to me, like,
because you're so just like, what do I need this house for? What
yeah,
do I need this for?
Life,
right?
Care,
yeah.
Like, in real life,
no, I know. That's what I'm saying.
Like, put me in a hammock outside.
You're
I'm
fine.
I'm going to figure this shit out. Anywhere I've ever been, bro, I figure this shit out.
Uh-huh.
Like, I'm from a black city, bro. I live in Utah, bro. Figure that shit out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, because all us in Utah, we are like, we need to have the house. We got to have the lawn. We got, and there's so much of this, like, keeping up with the Joneses.
That's every society. Even if you go to, let's say,
you don't think more here?
Hell,
okay,
bro.
Okay.
So if you go
I'm
to the ghetto
probably.
Society, it's worse than that, bro. Like, the most image-conscious person is a poor person whose competition is another poor person. Look, hey, I'm poor, but I'm not poorer than that motherfucker. You feel what I'm saying?
Oh.
So the competition is deeper, bro, because the competition for last place is way more serious than first place. Bro. I'm not going to be in last, bro.
Oh, my God.
You know what I'm saying?
What's up, Steve? Yo, meet Kai.
Hey, how's it going?
Saw him walking
up,
down the street. Saw him walking down the street. Was like, dude, you got to check out the martial arts gym. And fucking boom, here we are. What you about to go do?
Oh, just go eat.
Oh, nice.
I was going to ask you.
Yeah.
You said you still have some, a little bit more footage from that?
Oh, of that guy.
Yeah.
You want to look at it?
Yeah, yeah.